So when I tell people my car runs on CNG gas, the first thing they do is they don't believe until I open up the boot and I show them the cylinder. They now ask, how do I manage to buy gas when gas is so expensive? I have to now break it down that CNG is not LPG. LPG is mostly used for cooking. I decided to start the conversion of vehicles into a hybrid system of petrol and CNG, where CNG is the primary fuel because it's actually very good for the ecosystem. It's a green gas that releases less carbon emissions. Another reason is its economic benefit. Currently, you can get between 10 to 15 naira per kilometer on CNG versus about 60 to 65 naira per kilometer on petrol. Currently in Nigeria, to convert your car to a hybrid system of CNG and petrol would vary between the type of technology used, if it's the sequential or the Venturi, and also the type of vehicle itself. We're looking at between 400 and 700,000 naira. Some of the modifications done to vehicles when installing CNG. This high pressure line passes from the engine all the way to the trunk of the car where the CNG cylinder is installed. The high pressure gas comes to the reducer, reduces it, and passes that reduced pressure to the injector rails. The injector rails pass the gas through nozzles that will be drilled side by side with the original injector. Then you have an ECU. The ECU controls the operation of the gas between the engine and the original ECU of the car, and all that is synced up with this wire. The major disadvantages of having CNG in your vehicle is the loss of space. Usually space where you would fit your luggage is where you would put the cylinder. The more cylinders you have in a vehicle, the longer the travel distance you can get out of CNG. Another disadvantage of using CNG is performance. It would lower the engine's power output. The difference isn't so much, but it's something that you would notice. It's not that bad, but since you are driving economically, it's not much of a disadvantage. As per the safety of CNG, the cylinder wall thickness of the tank that is usually placed at the back of the car is about 6 millimeters. It is really, really thick. It is bulletproof in most cases when you use the type 1 and does not explode on impact. CNG gas has a very, very high flash point and it's lighter than air. So in the case of a leak, it goes up into the air, unlike LPG. Most people confuse LPG for CNG. There are a lot of safety precautions I take before installing CNG on any vehicle. Usually we start from the engine to ensure that the factory wiring is still intact. We check its coolant system, we check the timing belts, and generally to ensure that the vehicle has not been abused before installing. Then we further go on to check the underbody of the car to be sure it's rust-free and to ensure its suspension system is intact. So that way, we ensure that the vehicle's integrity, mechanical and electrical integrity, is still top-notch. It's maintenance-friendly. The engine stays cleaner for a very long time. Cycle of maintenance reduces, which means your cost reduces. It doesn't put holes in your pockets. See, there's a lot of savings to it. The initial lump sum might be much, but going down the line, 6 months, 9 months, it covers for it.